Yes, student, serious question. It's a very good question based on electrostatics. We have a very large slab of insulating material having face area A and dielectric constant K equal to 2. So here we have a dielectric material, okay, placed between two plates of parallel plate capacitor, okay. So there are two plates around the dielectric and some uniform charges on plates are given. All right. The system is placed in uniform electric field. The field is perpendicular to the surface of the material, so we have to find the total charge, free charge, bound charge, and the magnitude of the applied electric field. Now, what you see in this question, you can see that there is field given in the three regions, right? So, this electric field is the actual electric field present due to all the charges and the other field combined, okay? There's an external uniform electric field present in the system, and there are charges on the system. So, because of that, the resultant field created is shown in this diagram. Okay, so let's understand what is given to us. Let's say that the uniform external electric field is E. Okay, this is the external uniform electric field. All right, and we have got two plates of capacitor. These are the two plates. So the charges on the capacitor plates be, let's assume Q1 and Q2. Okay. Now there's a dielectric placed between the capacitor plates, right? So the surface of the dielectric will develop some amount of charge. Let's say that on this side of the dielectric we have a positive charge small q, and on this side of the dielectric we have a negative charge of same amount minus q. So these are your free charges on the plates, okay? And this Q and minus Q, these are your bound charges on the surface of the dielectric. So we have to find the value of E, Q1, Q2 and small q, okay? Now, we have the values E1, E2 and E3 in the three regions. Let's write them down. So here we have E1, here we have electric field E2, and here we have electric field E3. We have to calculate unknown parameters based on E1, E2 and E3. So first of all, let's take a Gaussian surface over here. Okay, let's take a Gaussian surface over here. So for this Gaussian surface, what is the flux? Here E1 field is entering the surface, here E2 field is leaving the surface. So flux will be how much? E2 times area will be positive because field is coming out, and E1 times area we have to write with a minus sign because the E1 field is going into the surface, okay? So this should be equal to total charge enclosed, Q1 minus Q. Q1 minus Q divided by epsilon naught. Now E2 and E1 are how much? E2 is 2Q by A epsilon naught, E1 is Q by A epsilon naught. So what you will be left with is Q by epsilon naught equal to Q1. Q by epsilon naught equal to Q1 minus Q by epsilon naught. So let's remove this epsilon naught from the denominator. Okay, so this is your first equation that we have. All right, now let's take one more Gaussian surface on the right side. So if I take this Gaussian surface, then in this Gaussian surface the field coming out is E3 over here, the field entering is E2 over here. So total flux will be how much? E3 times area minus E2 times area, that should be equal to how much? Charge enclosed, Q2 plus Q divided by epsilon naught. Q2 plus small q divided by epsilon naught. Okay. Now E3 and E2 are what? 3Q by A epsilon naught and 2Q by A epsilon naught. So you will get this to be equal to, again, Q by epsilon naught equal to Q2 plus small q by epsilon naught. So let's remove them. Okay. So this is my second equation. Now let's look at the options once. Total charge on right side, right surface is Q. So total charge here means what? Q2 plus Q, and Q2 plus Q is coming out to be equal to Q. So option A would be correct. Okay. Now we have got two equations, and in these two equations we have got three unknowns. We need more equations, right? So now let's look at the electric field in the center region E2. E2 will be what? Net electric field due to EQ1 minus Q plus Q and Q2. So let's write that down. So E2 will be equal to this electric field E plus due to Q1 and Q2, what will you get? Q1 will create field in this direction, Q2 will create field in opposite. So we have to basically subtract them. So Q1 minus Q2 by A, sorry, 2A epsilon naught. Okay. Then due to this Q1 minus Q, field will be added. So we'll get plus, sorry, again, minus we will get. Okay, actually we'll be getting minus sign. So Q by A epsilon naught. Okay. These two together are creating field in opposite direction. Okay. So this is your next equation. All right. So E2 is how much? E2 is given to be 2Q by A epsilon naught. So 2Q by A epsilon naught is equal to E plus Q1 minus Q2 by 2A epsilon naught minus Q by A epsilon naught. Now, first of all, you might be wondering, I have put factor 2 in denominator over here, but not in this formula. That is because I am calculating field due to the total charge on this plate Q1. So for the total charge on a plate, electric field is given by sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Okay. And when you take charges of opposite sign on either side, okay, then due to this Q charge, you will get Q by 2A epsilon naught. Due to this minus Q charge also, you will get minus Q by 2A epsilon naught. All right. So Q by 2A epsilon naught plus small Q by 2A epsilon naught. So you will get total Q by A epsilon naught. That's what I've used over there. Okay. So for this total charge on the plate, on the capacitor plate Q1, I have this formula Q1 by 2 epsilon naught, but for the total bound charge on both of the sides combined, I get this formula. Okay, this is not a single charge, this is the total due to the charges on either side of the dielectric, right? So this is my next equation. So 2Q is equal to, I should write down 4Q. 4Q is equal to 2A epsilon naught E plus Q1 minus Q2 plus minus 2Q. Okay. Now, this is my equation, right? Now, one more thing will happen. What if I take the field only due to the external field and the bound charge under, sorry, free charges? This is your electric field due to the external field and the free charges. So E plus Q1 minus Q2 by 2A epsilon naught. Okay. This is the electric field created by the charge system, and the dielectric is interfering with this electric field by creating its own field. What we could say is that this multiplied by 1 by k should be equal to E2. Actual electric field in vacuum divided by dielectric constant gives you the net field in the dielectric medium, right? So this is the actual field in vacuum if dielectric was not present. Okay, clear? So this is the actual field in vacuum, and divided by dielectric constant gives me the net field, okay, over there, right? So this is my one more equation. So E, k is 2, right? So E by 2 plus Q1 minus Q2 by 4A epsilon naught is equal to E2. E2 is 2Q by A epsilon naught. 2Q by A epsilon naught. So from here I get again 2E plus Q1 minus Q2. 2E A epsilon naught plus Q1 minus Q2 is equal to 8Q. All right. So this is the another equation that I get. Now, I have got how many equations? This is my first equation, second equation. Okay. And this is my third equation. And finally, this is my fourth equation. So from here, I will use this value 2EA epsilon naught plus Q1 minus Q2 is equal to 8Q. Let's put that in this equation for this part. Okay. So 4Q is equal to, this will be 8Q minus 2 small q. So 4Q equal to 8Q minus 2Q. From here, what you get, 8Q minus 4 is 4, 4 by 2 is 2. So Q will be equal to 2Q. Okay. Then let's find out Q1. So Q1 will be Q plus Q, so that is 3Q, and Q2 will be what? Q2 will be capital Q minus small q, so that is equal to minus Q. And finally, we can calculate the electric field over here. Electric field will be how much? Let's use this formula. So E will be equal to 4 q by a epsilon naught plus q2 minus q1 by 2 a epsilon naught. So this is equal to 4 q by a epsilon naught plus q2 minus q1. So minus q minus 3 q minus 4 q minus 4 q by 2 a epsilon naught. Okay. So this is equal to 2 q by a epsilon naught. That is the value of E. Now let's just check the options finally. The free charge on the left surface is 3 q. On the left surface, free charge is Q1 and Q1 is equal to 3Q. So option B is correct. The bound charge on the right surface is 2Q. So bound charge on the right surface is what? Small q, and small q is equal to 2Q. So option C is also correct. The magnitude of the applied electric field is 2Q by A epsilon naught, and that is also correct, right? 2Q by A epsilon naught. So here all the four options will be correct. Clear?